Hamilton eating Oreos in a parked car.
I was chosen for the
Oreos in a parked car.
The monster's gone. He's on the run, and your daddy's here. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy.
Oh,
son of a...
Watch your language.
Fun.
You're close.
Frick.
Don't test me.
Shoot, dang it.
Oh my god.
Ass.
Sorry it took me so.
Ooh, hen, you'll never believe what happened.
No, I know.
There's a musical curse over Swell.
Yeah, I know.
And you'll never believe who did it.
Frankini?
Frankini!
Yeah, I know.
Ooh, hen, you'll never believe how he did
it. The speakers.
He took control of the speakers.
Yeah, I know.
And then put out a weird kind of frequency and now we have to sing.
Jasper!
Yeah?
Thanks for filling me in.
I don't know what to say. Let me. Don't be mean about it, though.
Hey, guys, look at this new dress my mom bought me. Sweet! It's a jumpsuit! You were fooled!
We think bullying is a serious issue. Just to be clear, we're against it.
Anyone can get bullied. It doesn't matter who you are. Check out some of these real comments people said about us.
Caleb, you got a big forehead. Seriously?
Oh, here's a clever one. Laura is an idiot.
Rainy Rodriguez is annoying and makes me want to vomit. Well, I hope you're not watching the show on a full stomach.
I hate Ross Lynch because he's ugly, stupid, weird, untalented, and he gets on my nerves. Wow, I think they pretty much covered everything.
Civil about this. Let's make a deal. You surrender and you don't die. How does that sound?
And how do you intend to kill us?
Oh, no, I can't kill you. But my buddy can. Say hi, buddy.
Dan has a very strange patchwork of knowledge. It's anybody's guess as to what he knows about any given topic. Watch.
Hey, Dan, who sculpted Mount Rushmore?
Gutzon Borglum. Then his son finished it. Why?
And what state is it in?
I don't know, Ecuador or something.
Call 911!
Why? What's happening? What's the deal?
Hello? Answer me! What's happening?
We're good, never mind.
What happened? What was going on?
It doesn't matter, we're fine.
It does matter! What provoked you?
Okay. Oh.
Don't make anything offensive, Chris.
Aw, it's just a smiley face. Look at that. He's just
look
angry.
At that little guy.
No!
He's angry.
No!
Scale of 1 to 10, how bad is it?
Oh, I'd say it's about a 7-point arm ripped off.
My arm is wet.
I'm losing all the wasting your
What did you draw?
A dog, and he's bored. What did you draw?
A stick.
A stick?
A stick from the park where you promised to take me today!
Should we blame the government or blame society?
Or should we blame the images on TV?
No! Blame Kavanaugh! Blame Kavanaugh! For the beady little eyes and reprehensible little eyes! Blame Kavanaugh! Blame Kavanaugh! We need to form a full assault!
I can't believe you've never felt this magic before. There's glitter in my brain and there's trash on my floor. Same song has been repeating for 3 or 4 days. I can't pay attention to whatever you're saying. I wanna talk about a movie but I'm feeling ignored. So I'll cry in my corner and I'll watch it some more. I only like things when I see where they're going. There's no greater fear than the fear of not knowing. And what is more exciting than making up a world inside your mind? And what is more intriguing than being over analytical sometimes? Do you not see how it's connected? Is your body not affected? I will tell you and you'll forget by tonight. trying to ignore, but I got jitters of excitement that I feel in my core. What do you mean I'm too old to be spinning around? How else do you cope with all the treasure you found inside a book, inside a movie, and in science and space? How does your body sit still? Does your mind not start to race? How can I explain? Some things make me so happy that my shoulders start to wiggle and my hands start flapping. What is more delightful than giving in to what fills you with joy? And why would I subject myself to being bothered by being called annoying? I guess you might not get it, but I hope that you will admit it's overrated to act grown up all the time. And that's fine. It's not your brain, it's mine.
The use of flash photography is strictly mandatory. Do you think I look like this just so I can exist in your feeble memory? Take a picture and I'll last forever.
You ever just watch something and think, wow, everyone in this is gay? That's how I felt watching this movie. That's a fucking twink. That's a pansexual, if I've ever seen one. That is a lesbian. That is a fucking lesbian. Look at that. That is a lesbian. Goob looked like a homosexual man who made some bad decisions in his 20s. Have you ever met a bisexual that doesn't look like this? Gay. This hat was fucking gay. I don't know what to tell you. It was gay. Buddy, I don't know what you are, but you're sure as hell not cisgender. He was the exception.
We blame the government or blame society?
Or should we blame the images on TV?
No! Right hand it off! Right hand it off! For their beady little eyes and flap their heads so full of lies! Right hand it off! Right hand it off! We need to form a full assault!
Right hand it off!
What are you sleeping?
Well, I adore Chanel number 5 and not much more.
Any advice for a girl in the city?
If you're two-faced, at least make one of them pretty.
The studio says lateness is your favorite crime.
Two, I've been on a calendar, but never on time.
When you pose nude, your inhibitions were gone?
Well, that's not quite true. I kept the radio on.
Like the Atlantic, and I'm going down. Like the Titanic.
Ice blue, like the Atlantic, and I'm going down. Like the Titanic.
Like the Atlantic, and I'm going down. Like the Titanic.
Eyes blue, like the Atlantic, and I'm going down. Like the Titanic.
There once was a man that was sleepy, so the man brewed himself a pot of coffee, but the coffee did not awaken him, so he drank more and more. Soon then anxiety comes, buzzing, jittering vibrations, now cause of caffeination, he's just anxious and tired.
Today, everyone.
But what about you, Captain?
Yeah, what happened down there?
Oh, let's see. I was struck by lightning, eaten by a giant clam, stung by a jellyfish, attacked by barracudas, escaped on the back of a blue whale, smashed into a shipwreck, freed myself, ran out of air, and, oh yeah, found you.
Ah, there you are. I was wondering where you had... Oh. Oh, dear. Are you all right? Your head is rather crowded today. Hmm. Well, there's not much I can do from here. I'm just a man in a recording booth, after all. However, I'm not at ease just leaving you like this. No, no. No, it wouldn't do at all. I'll help, but I'm only doing this once, so pay attention. You are loved. What? What do you mean you don't think so? Of course you are. Why wouldn't you be? Your brain isn't telling the truth. You are loved. How do I know? Well, let's move on. Look, here's another thought. People care about you. Unbelievable, yes, really. I can't help but feel it would take less energy to accept my words as they are instead of... Well, it isn't exactly fair of me to ask you to just be better. Still, it seems obvious to me that you are deeply cared for. By who? The specifics don't matter. You just have to trust me. I know it's hard to believe, but you've got to try. Because I can see how much your current thought patterns are hurting you. And believe it or not, you don't deserve to be hurt like this. Why do I care? I don't. Not at all. I'm doing this for me. If you're so occupied with self-hatred that you can't pay attention to me, who will listen to my majestic voice? This is for my benefit, not yours. Clearly you need some additional help. Perhaps a more direct statement. Now listen closely, this is important. You have a choice. Two paths diverged in a yellow wood. Sound familiar? One path leads down into darkness, apathy, anger, hatred for self and others. The other is different. It's much harder to walk, but it is much better for you. These are the choices we make every day, and every time you walk the better path, difficult though it may be, someone, somewhere, is proud of you. I know I am.
Are y'all ready for the saddest sounding squeaky toy? Why does it sound so sad? It's just...
Deep down, you know, you weren't built for fighting. But that doesn't mean you're not prepared to try. What they don't know is your real advantage. When you live for someone, you're prepared to die.
Deep down, I know that I'm just a human.
True,
but I know that I can draw my sword and fight. With my short existence,
good.
I can make a difference.
Yes, excellent.
I can be there for him. I can be his knight. I can do it for him. You do it for her.
Okay, now do that again.
Yes, ma'am.
You do it for her, and now you say,
I'll do it for him.
Oh, I can't believe I'm doing this. All right, here goes.
I'm your twin, you're my twin. We stick together through thick and thin. No matter what I do, I'm always stuck with you. And if trouble comes our way, I know my twin will save the day. Wherever you may be, you're always stuck with me.
We have a bond that's tried and true.
is it supposed to be a stealth mission? Is it supposed to be because there's so many men? And you're supposed to be like, oh, I possibly can't murder my way through all of these. Because that's not called having a can-do attitude, is it? If you look at a well-fortified building filled with soldiers and you think to yourself, I can't possibly get in there without stealth, well, you're not trying hard enough. With enough brute strength and stupidity, you can conquer anything. Always remember that.
Responsibility is mine.
No, I'm the responsible one.
Guys, you're both too valuable to risk. It should be someone expendable, like Jay.
What?
For the record, this is self-destructive. For the record, I'm aware of that.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front line, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over.
I missed on purpose.
I'm not giving up on him.
When you fold it up, oh, oh, and if you fold it up, eh, eh, time it out, mira sangalewa, cause this is Africa.
You've ever had. You think I'm psycho, you think I'm gone. Tell the psychiatrist something is wrong. Over the bend, entirely bonkers. You like me best when I'm off my rocker. Tell you a secret, I'm not alarmed. So what if I'm crazy, the best people are.
Stop eating
the poison!
Sorry, I missed that. Can you repeat everything from, well, everything? No wonder you always want to train. You really need the practice.
I want to scream and shout and let it all out. And scream and shout and let it out.
Trap doors in the 444 me. Focus on the love and the light right before me. Walls keep spinning and my path keeps
turning. Patience spinning and my calves keep burning. Hotter than a furnace, suddenly I'm learning. Maybe I finally reached the point of no returning. East is north and west is south. I feel like I can never get out. I'm trapped.
Oh my god, are you seriously going to do this right now? Look, I'm trying to get better, but I can't do that when every goddamn thing's about you! And why do I have to figure out why I'm like this and still treat you like a princess? But what about me? I'm a fucking princess too, so treat me like one and don't tell me what to do!
Oh! Hey, guys!
And here!
Honestly, I don't know. We already hit him with everything we got, so insert Dad's plan here.
I got nothing.
Oh, all we need to do is figure out what the Twilight Realm is, where it is, how to get there, how to get out, how to use the weapon, and probably some other stuff. No. I got just the plan to get him out.
If you die in this maze, I will haunt you for the rest of your life.
Well, in theory, you'd both be ghosts, so I'm not sure how you would...
Donnie, not helping!
Rev, when the single greatest actor in the history of low-budget sci-fi invites you to his headquarters, you say yes. Yes.
Oh, I see. You're full-on crazy. Guys, just wanted to point out that these villains are actually regular people in costumes. Just wanted to make it clear so we're all on the same page.
When a vacant head sphere walks, they tend to lead with their head. They also tend to walk with a purpose, even if they don't have anywhere to be.
Walking, gotta walk, gotta get there. Where is there? I don't remember. Wait! I'm just taking a stroll through the park. Gotta walk.
They also tend to have a bounce in their step. So if they're wearing a ponytail, that thing swings like a 1930s big band. Next up is eye contact, specifically while talking to someone. Vacant head spheres are a little funny this way. They have the ability to hold eye contact, but they just don't wanna. They're still listening. Their brain is just multitasking. When vacant head spheres sit, they tend to sit on the very edge of the seat. And when it comes to hand gestures, vacant head spheres use their hands when talking a lot. It's like their mouth is directly connected to their hands. The intellectual head sphere. But again, this has nothing to do with intelligence. An intellectual head sphere could technically be a dum-dum. But honestly, I have never come across anyone who acted this way that wasn't a big old brainy nerd about something. Much like their twin, intellectual head spheres will sit on the very edge of their seat and also lead with their head when they walk. Minus the ponytail swinging bounce, of course. But in direct contrast to their boisterous sibling, when you start to speak to an intellectual head sphere, they must immediately stop what they are doing and very intently stare directly at you while you talk, to an almost intimidating degree. Intellectual head spheres like doing very small things with their hands while talking or thinking, like fiddling with a pen or a coin, twiddling their thumbs, and their gestures are very small and understated. It just feels like this character sphere is the embodiment of the term mild-mannered, the librarian of the bunch. Moving on, you have the heart sphere, a favorite of mine, probably because I share the most traits with this one. This sphere is basically Miss Bianca from the Rescuers movies. First of all, heart spheres have very good posture when they walk because they lead with their chest. Guess you could say they follow their hearts? Now, when a heart sphere is talking to you, they maintain eye contact very well. But the key is their eyes react very empathetically with whatever it is you're saying, whether it's happy, sad, angry, what have you. You never second guess if a heart sphere is actually listening to you.
Wow, the heart sphere is big on empathy. It's like a villain being named Reginald McEvil Man.
When it comes to a heart sphere's hand gestures, everything is centered around the heart, to a literal degree. They touch their chests a lot, that's what I'm saying. This sphere is also the only sphere that sits in a chair like a normal person.
They don't sit on the edge, their butt is perfectly where it needs to be, taking up the correct amount of space for a humanoid.
Now we get to the will sphere. I used to think of this one as the cowboy sphere until I got corrected the other day. To start off, when a will sphere walks, they lead with their hips. They kind of have that cowboy swagger about them. I described this to a friend of mine recently, and he said, "Oh, like supermodels." Yeah, that checks out. Now I think of this as the strut sphere. The sphere of strut. The stratosphere! Okay, so will spheres don't really use their hands all that much when talking. They only gesture once or twice, but when they do, you gotta step back because it's always something big. Like they're laughing at something funny and they slap the table, or it's a get out of here hand gesture, or big finger guns. They expend all their gesture points in one go. I don't know if this is intentional, but Will's spheres will maintain eye contact with you while talking like they're trying to assert dominance. This is another reason why I used to call them the cowboy sphere, because they stare at you like it's high noon and one of you is about to cash in your warranty. Supermodels do it too. That catwalk stare looks like you murdered their family and now they're gonna remove your vital organs through your ears. Legend says that when a Will sphere and an intellectual head sphere have a staring competition, it never ends. Ever. And last but not least, if you have ever known someone in your life that regularly claims an entire couch for themselves, they were probably a Will sphere. They don't just sit in the seat, they take up the seat. The person could be 4'10", 105 pounds, and somehow they can magically take up every inch of a sofa. Obviously, this is all just for the yucks, just some good old-fashioned Tommy Rot what. Don't take any of it too seriously.
That is what you get for playing Space Camp with Captain Cuckoo.
Write it down, I say. But no, the brain is like just no pad.
Hey.
Not really. There's a pigeon with pizza in its mouth. It's a pizza pigeon. I knew you guys could do it.
No, you didn't. I did.
Oh, you want to go?
Bring it.
Johnny, if you don't cut it out with your middle child nonsense, I'm going to shove your head in the toilet.
Skee-ball.
Johnny, I know you know how to say it. We're all on to you. Stop eating the poison! What? Pets love me, all right? I am at one with the animals. I'm on my way! Tell my little buddy Mayhem to hang tight! Yeah, my face takes damage like a boss!
Saving like a boss!
That reminds me of a dream I had where I was kissing a girl. Uh-huh. Good save.
A simple song.
Is this your hat?
That was until you came along.
Here you go.
Thanks. Now in its place is something.
See you later.
New. I hear it when I look
yeah.
at you.
See you later.
Okay, so these are my disaster twin headcanons, and so we know the ordering is Raph is the oldest, then it's the twins, Donnie and Leo, and then it's Mikey. I headcanon that Leo is oldest, not oldest, sorry, but he's like older than Donnie, so he's the oldest twin, and that whenever him and Donnie are arguing, Leo's always like, well, I'm older, and I've been here longer, so therefore, I'm right. And Donnie, this pisses him off. Donnie gets so mad when he hears this. He's like, that's not how that works. That's not how logic and reasoning works. But Leo doesn't care about logic and reasoning. Only Donnie does. And this is one of the reasons Leo says it so often. Because he knows it pisses Donnie off. And Donnie really doesn't have a comeback for it. Other than, you know, hitting him in the head. So that's what happens. Like, every, I would say maybe like 2 or 3 times a day. They get in an argument, and Leo's just like, well, I'm older, and I'm better than you, so you're wrong. And Donnie just whacks him.
Donnie, these are amazing.
And I know everything I say sounds sarcastic, but I'm being completely genuine. This time. Oh, sure, let me just load my Tap Into Every Security Camera in New York app. I'm sorry if that sounded like sarcasm. It wasn't. I am in.
Yo, am I the only one who's noticed that these two type of people are, like, always best friends?
Oh my god, can we, like, just fucking go home already? Like, I'm trying to take a nap. I fucking hate my life. Why is everyone looking at me?
Josh, you have to see the
sun. The floor is lava!
What?
We're going to a candy store?
No, it's nighttime. Candy stores are closed.
We're gonna rob a candy store?
It is hot as hell in this fucky ass, hot ass room I'm in.
Is that the Grim Reaper?
Trenches and you're under fire, I will cover you. If I was dying on my knees, you would be the one to rescue me. And if you were drowned at sea, I'd give you my lungs so you could breathe. I've got you, brother.
I am an artist, please God forgive me. I am an artist, please don't revere me. I am an artist, please don't respect me. I am an artist, feel free to correct me. A self-centered artist, self-obsessed artist. I am an artist, I am an artist. But I'm just a kid, I'm just a kid. I'm just a kid, kid. And maybe I'll grow out of it.
And close your eyes.
They want our leaders to save the day.
We don't get a say in what they trade away.
We dream of a brand new start.
But we dream in the dark for the most part.
Dark as a tomb where it happens.
I've got to be in the road.
Where it happens.
I've got to be.
Where it happens.
I've got to be.
Where it happens.
I've got to be in the room.
People are simply better than others.
You really think you're that much better than me?
Oh, I think we both know the answer to that.
I know it's time to say goodbye. So hard to let go.
This might be more complicated than I thought.
I think I broke something.
Walk it off!
I'm doing everything I can.
You're not doing enough!
What are you writing? The government wants to know what kind of weapons we have in the house. I'm letting them know it's private information. This just says fuck around and find out in calligraphy.
I wear your granddad's clothes. I look incredible. I'm in this big old coat from that thrift shop down the road.
Hey, he wears your granddad's clothes.
That's right.
He looks incredible.
I do.
He's in that big old coat.
It's from
that thrift shop down
let's
the road.
Go.
I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is super awesome.
How come nobody trusts me? None of you guys have any faith in me. Why?
Good thing you didn't do Leo's idea of being afraid of spiders.
Since you sell the fewest action figures, why don't you go ahead and jump first?
Who doesn't love my one-liner? They fire up the team, right, guys?
Hey, one of Leo's portals didn't work. We all totally expected.
I need my brainy guy and my smashy guy and my eats peanut butter with his fingers guy. I'm nothing without them.
Dang it, Leo. Everything's not about you. When are you gonna grow up and start acting like a hero?
Look, I keep being told I'm doing this hero thing wrong. But I got the key, didn't I? I get results.
There has to be another way.
We've tried everything, Case. This is the only way.
Leo, please don't do this. Leo!
You're one to talk, big bro. Hero moves are totally your style.
How do I unbake a cake? You can't. Once the ingredients are mixed up and baked, it's perfect.
Okay, I'm going to need you to listen to me very carefully. Put it back in the oven. Set it to the negative of whatever temperature you baked it at, such as minus 325 degrees, and leave it in for the exact amount of time you baked it for. It has to be exact. If you unbake it too much, the flour may turn into wheat and the eggs will turn into a chicken. Don't ask me how.
And registration. Oh, I'm sorry, mate. I must have left it in my other jacket.
Who are you? Why do you have a picture of us?
Yeah, who took this? Because I look great.
What's your favorite pizza? Because I'm ordering it right now.
Why are you...
I have to get to the key.
See ya.
Get them. Don't let them interfere with the ceremony!
Open and bring unto this world the mighty power of Krang!
Do you smell something rotting?
There's nothing here, stop talking.
I swear there's something spotting.
I'm telling you it's nothing.
Are you afraid to discuss it?
You're talking crazy, is it me or are you an idiot?
If you take a man who is willing to do anything for his son, and you take away his son, there is no limit to what that man will do to get revenge.
Was it the best you ever had?
What's green and it has wheels?
I don't know, a green bike?
Grass! I lied about the wheels!
Who broke it? I'm not mad, I just want to know.
I did. I broke it.
No, you didn't. Tom?
Don't look at me. Look at Ben.
What? I didn't break it.
Huh, that's weird. How'd you even know it was broken?
Because it's sitting right in front of us, and it's broken.
Suspicious.
No, it's not.
If it matters, probably not, but April was the last one to use it.
Liar, I don't even drink that crap.
Oh, really? Then what were you doing by the coffee cart earlier?
I used the wooden stirrers to push back my cuticles. Everyone knows that,
okay,
Jerry.
Okay, let's not fight. I broke it. Let me pay for it, Ron.
No. Who broke it?
Ron, Donna's been awfully quiet.
Really?
Oh, yeah, really.
Oh, now, he's gonna say Donna.
I broke it. It burned my hand, so I punched it. I predict 10 minutes from now, they'll be at each other's throats with war paint on their faces and a pig head on a stick.
At least I have my cigarettes, but I don't have a lighter. I hope no bitches steal my look, cause I'ma have to fight her. I tried to call Aisha, but her phone is fucking dead.
Sorry.
Oh, whatever, I'll try again later, I'll call this twink instead.
Now why y'all worry about the fuck I do? I'ma let y'all know when the fuck I'm through. Now why y'all worry about the fuck I do? I'ma let y'all know when the fuck I'm through. Now why y'all worry about the fuck I do? I'ma let y'all know when the fuck I'm through. Now why y'all worry about the fuck I do? I'ma let y'all know when the fuck I'm through. Like, they like the way I grind, they like the way I flirt, they like the way my loony is peeking on my skirt.
Any votes for staying home during the anti-mutant panic? No? Okay. Let's go!
You could smash the mirror!
You can't smash the mirror with a minute. Mike is trapped in the netherworld.
Okay, check this out. The spine-breaking bandit.
Yeah! Go big or go home!
Yeah, go home on a stretcher. What else you got?
Okay, here's something. The Long Island Mangler.
Okay, Donnie, I appreciate you giving your best effort, but maybe we should save mangling and spine breaking for, I don't know, our second day?
Rath? Hey, Rath?
Huh? What happened?
Oh, you passed out trying to single-handedly lift a school bus. So when she kept growing, that wasn't a clue to stop screaming?
Sorry, but hopefully Raph heard me.
Astronauts heard you.
Guys, we found him! Look! 1000% not Raph, staking my life on it shorts.
Raph! Unload!
It might be Raph, but who's to say anymore? I'll blast him with the boom cannons!
Johnny, Chad's in that thing.
Can I at least go semi-lethal? You never let me shine!
Exactly what we're gonna do, guys.
Stealth mode!
Or stealth mode.
This calls for the delicate touch of a genius.
I'll cover the sound for you! We should be through in a couple of hours!
Quiet, or we'll never get the book to Free Mayhem.
You got yourself a deal.
Raph, what are we getting into? In case you haven't noticed, these mystic types have a nasty habit of trying to kill us.
And he's only attacking people in red bandanas.
Huh, it's like someone who wears a red bandana really hurt this guy's feelings once. Strange.
Which one will you choose?
Give him the bugs! Just give him the bugs!
I'm not giving him the bugs. These villains are all talk. He ain't gonna
do...
No!
With my last breath, I told you so! We should go. People's blinds are starting to open.
Don't matter what you think, a different gender best friend is a red flag. I'm sorry, Emily. I don't think we can be friends anymore.
Hey, guys, look at this new dress my mom bought me. Sweet! It's a jumpsuit! You were fooled!
I bet you were scared, huh?
Scared? Me? I'm never scared.
Stop chewing so fucking loud, bro.
Leave that little guy alone. The fuck is you gonna do if I don't?
Having trouble figuring out who's Barbie's BFF, huh?
It's me!
It's me!
It's me!
It's probably not me.
And then there were two.
I know.
You know what, though?
Nobody likes us. The two bitches are left.
I was trauma dumping on this first grader about how stressed out I am about this exam I have coming up. And I was like, are you stressed out about anything, dude? And he was like, well, I do have a spelling test on Friday. And I was like, okay, dog, like, You didn't have to one-up me like that. Not cool, seriously.
That's enough! Hand over my uncle, or else!
Now, isn't this interesting?
Voila.
We just back the fuck.
Mama didn't raise no fucking bitch. We keep going.
No. Mama raised the business girl.
Mama didn't raise nobody, actually. My mom was absent.
Oh my god.
Now, where are the gays?
Over here.
No, the really cartoony gays.
Yoo-hoo!
There you are. We're gonna need you guys all week.
Wait a minute. Who the fuck did you have in here? Why is the seat back like that? And why do this car smell like Japanese cherry blossom? Who the fuck did you have in here?
Well, I think you're mad that I'm funny and awesome and cool. If those are your daily affirmations, you need new ones. Help!
What is your favorite drink?
Water with a lemon slice.
What's your favorite food?
Water with a lime slice.
What's your guilty pleasure?
Water with a cucumber slice.
Favorite dessert?
Carrots.
Can I shoot her? Not in public.
Proof that not everything can be a movie poster.
Before I die, I'd like to do something nice. Take it for a ride.
Little reminder for the gays.
you can't hate yourself. That's homophobic.
The winner of last year's...
As five-time champ, I'd like you all to stand while I speak.
Oh, yeah!
Any whizzle.
Fab. F-A-B. Foam agent bonding. It's state-of-the-art. Could
not
change
this again.
The entire
you see,
way
Raph, usually when Donnie's in speech mode, I could just run away, but now I'm stuck. Looks like these fish are... Wait for it, you're gonna love this. All washed up. Hey, no more, huh? Mis hermanos. I'll use my ultra-reliable portaling sword to get us there. Ha! Okay, well, when he gets here, we'll deal with him. Oh, I see you're doing that whole sinister talking in the third person thing.
She? I know you're not talking about the thing we talked about, never talking about.
Whoa, we really broke this poor guy.
Want a skateboard? Come on, what about all your secrets?
Second place, huh? What's that feel like?
Nardo, please don't.
Because I only get first.
Sheldon, who would have thought a team full of Donnies would be more nightmare than dream come true? Not I, that's for sure.
Yeah, you beefed it.
Yes, I beefed it. Well, we know what we must do.
I'll ready the disposal unit.
She's a wonderful nurse, although Father says...
Girls talk too much.
Yes, girls talk too...
Well, get on with it, girl.
My name is Wendy. Wendy Mora Angela Dawson.
Wendy's enough.
Told me I was awful and that shit did not faze me. Tell me how I suck again, my memory is hazy. You're my favorite rapper now, yeah, dude, I better be. Or you can fucking kiss my ass, human centipede.
Donnie, what's your password?
Try, I love my family. Try, I love my brothers.
Stop! It's not that! It's
Booty Shaker 9000. Capital B and three Y's in booty.
I wasn't sure they knew what a week was.
Dude, let me say this in a language you can understand.
No.
Cool, cool, cool. Cool, cool, cool. What a day.
This is a job for Dr. Delicate Touch.
Rise of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Heroes in the half shell.
Turtle Power.
Rising up against evil, paint the city green.
Rap is ready for a fight.
Leo's making a scene.
Mikey's got